This is an introduction to the endocrine system. So this is the hypothalamus. The hypothalamus is in the brain. It communicates with the anterior pituitary gland through the bloodstream, and then it communicates with the posterior pituitary gland through these long axons of neurons. So oxytocin and the antidiuretic hormone, they're made in the hypothalamus, but then they are sent down to the posterior pituitary gland, and then they're stored there until they're needed. The hypothalamus secretes hormones that are going to direct the anterior pituitary gland to either produce or not produce these six hormones. So we have human growth hormone, it's going to target the bones and the muscles. Follicle stimulating hormone, it's going to target ovaries and testes for follicular production. Luteinizing hormone is responsible for secondary sex hormones such as estrogen and testosterone. Prolactin stimulates milk production in the mammary glands. Thyroid stimulating hormone stimulates the thyroid to make T3 and T4. Adrenocorticotropic hormone, this stimulates the adrenal cortex to produce long-term stress hormones. The parafollicular cells in the thyroid gland secrete calcitonin, which decreases blood calcium levels. The parathyroid glands are on the posterior side of the thyroid gland, and they secrete parathyroid hormone. This increases blood calcium levels. So calcitonin and parathyroid hormone are opposite hormones. The pancreas is both an endocrine and an exocrine gland. The endocrine part secretes insulin, which decreases blood sugar, and glucagon, which increases blood glucose levels. And those hormones are secreted from the islet cells in the pancreas. The Sini cells that are in the pancreas are the exocrine gland part, and they release digestive enzymes and buffers for the digestive system. The ovaries and the testes are going to produce secondary sex hormones directed by luteinizing hormone. The adrenal gland sits on top of the kidney. So renal means kidney, and the adrenal gland is on top of the kidney. The adrenal medulla secretes epinephrine and norepinephrine. These are the short stress hormones, and they play a role in the fight or flight response. The pineal gland in the brain secretes melatonin, and that helps regulate your circadian rhythm. The thymus is in the mediastinum. So if we take off the sternum, we can see here's the mediastinum, here's the heart, and the thymus sits on top of the heart. The white blood cells called T lymphocytes mature here.